Principal Mrs. Tyranny Militant speaking. We'd like to inform you that next week is the most important week of the year. Testing! Want to graduate? Well, then you better do well. Oh, yes. And on another note, whichever of you broke into the school computer system, set off all the alarms and the sprinklers, and erased the freshman transcript will be found and punished in the most extreme manner! Thank you and have a wonderful day.
What? Why is everyone looking at me? I would never do something like erase the freshman transcripts or set up all of the sprinklers.
Whatever! We all know you didn't. I can barely pass computer science, and you're hacking into the school computer system? Dude, I love you.
Like I say, I didn't do anything. Uh-huh.
Yeah. Right. The real question is, how do you get away with that stuff?
Man, you may think I'm weird, but I love being the class geek. I've got this whole place under the click of my mouse. I've got over 500 gigs of pirated music on my computer. I reached level 70 in World of Warcraft in just 5 minutes, man. Man, I got all of the president's emails from the first day he was inaugurated. I have enough knowledge to initiate a full-blown internet shutdown. Man, it's just too easy. But why, people ask? Because I can.
Well, I hope whoever it is that keeps messing with the school computer system erases all our transcripts. Are you serious?
Or at least modifies them just a little.
No way. I did not work all these years for my information to just disappear.
Chill, it's not the end of the world.
Yes, it is. Next week is tested, and then I have papers due in every one of my AP classes before spring break. Plus, I haven't even heard back from my summer internship yet.
Wow.
Finger painting and glitter glue? Now that was the business! It was all about creative expression. Now that's all secondary. Nobody cares if you can wrap the periodic table or sketch the Civil War, because the answer is A, B, C, or D. And the lesson is simple. If it isn't testable, it isn't valuable. But what do tests measure anyway? Some white upper middle class version of reality? So, everyone, take hold of your number two pencil and brace yourselves, because you're all in for one long, inevitable, racist, sexist, homophobic, xenophobic, physically, emotionally, and psychologically oppressive ride! My classmates, they have no idea I think about any of this. They think I'm the girl that only cares about her GPA and her SAT scores. And yeah, I care. But I only care because I gotta make it out of here. Out of this labyrinth of education with something to look forward to. If I think too much about the ride, I'll never make it. She can't think about it. I wish I could stop thinking about it. It's like racism and sexism are burning through me like a wildfire out of control. Everywhere I turn, I hear another voice saying, "You can't." And I'm tired. Tired of people talking like racism is a thing of the past. Slavery's over, honey. Move on. Not when 44% of the prison population is black. I'm tired of people telling me that women have the same rights as men do. You just need to work hard and everything will work out just fine. I'm tired of watching myself buy into the madness. Like when people use the N-word as a term of endearment, I say it too. It just pops out of my mouth sometimes like nothing. I wish I could stop thinking about it all, but I can't.
Thank you.
the weekends. You'll find me behind the cash register at El Zamorano. But I hate being invisible. I'm right here. I have the right to be looked in my eyes. The thing is that if you really saw me, you'd have to kick me out.
Thank you.
new high-tech gadget of the month.
Our sportswear, our business wear.
Smiling for me, yeah. means this is my girlfriend. She loves me all the time. For the irony of it all is that she loves me all the time.
Oh, see?
Actually, I'm already getting one.
Nah, man, not a cookie cutter tour.
Smarty pants, but did you know that the work on level one is pretty much identical to the work on level two?
What? What do you mean?
Same jump, different color hoop, you know what I mean? Nothing real is being created here anymore. That's all done overseas. The only thing we create here is trashola.
Trashola?
Garbage, waste, rubbish, which is also sent back overseas.
Overseas?
And also to the giant island of trash, of course.
Island of what?
The giant island of trash, fool. Dang, you're so gullible.
Well, it's just, dude, I didn't
All right, let me explain. There's this huge island of trash the size of Texas that's just chilling out in the Pacific Ocean. It's mostly made of plastic. It's said to be decomposable in about, let me see, 7 trillion years.
What? Isn't anyone doing anything about it?
Of course they are. Adding more to it every day.
Isn't that bad for the planet?
Duh.
That can't be true. Doesn't anyone else know?
I think so. But they just ignore it. See her over there? She knows. She just keeps on working. Hey, come meet my new friend. Hey, over here.
Shh. What are you doing? You're going to get me into trouble again. Hi.
Man, just chill out.
I can't.
No one's coming. They're still trying to figure out how to get the alarm turned off anyway.
I wonder who's responsible for that.
You know, who's really running stuff around here?
You're good, Glitch. I'll give you that. But the factory is running stuff.
Oh, I'm so scared. The almighty corporation called the factory.
Exactly. The corporation. Their game is so tight, they use the amendment that gave former slaves equal rights for their own benefit. They become a person. They have the same rights as individuals, but with way more money. And as we all know, money gets you whatever you want. So in some areas, the corporation even owns water. When it rains, people can't even collect it without getting fined.
Dang, that's just wrong.
Mm-hmm.
Well, if you understand the system so well, then what are you doing up here on level one, letting the game take advantage of you?
I don't have time for this. I have to get back to work.
Dropout number 49236986. Dropout number 49236986.
Oh, that's me. All right, I gotta go. Don't worry, you can see me real soon.
Here you are. Everything is under control. I heard they already found the one that pushed the emergency button and blasted him into the stratosphere.
Sure. Whatever you say.
Nothing goes unnoticed in this factory. So let's continue the tour. Level two, come right up.
Addicted to consuming,
addicted to getting by, addicted to producing and consuming, producing and consuming. Ah, they're the ones that make this factory tick. We are so proud of them. Without them, there would be no factory.
Yeah, here we go. Yeah. So whatever it is, institutionalism, racism, capitalism, industrialism, but I guess we start with materialism. How is God all people up in the prison? Cause we gotta have an iPod camera with a tripod. We use things that life thinks K-pop. Why you gotta have clothes that feel three dresses when a lot of people live off much lesser? Just cause you can buy anything don't mean you should get the rehab like the little engine that could. Now I'm going fast like Miami Vice. In this country we use shopping as our vice. We addicted to shopping, consumer fiends, and that's not much better than the crack fiends. Your worldly possessions don't make you you. It's about the actions and the things you do. Strung up, hooked on, sniffed up, stuck on ADD, ICTED. You gon' get off of me, you gon' get off of me, you gon' get off of me, you gon' get off. Strung up, hooked on, sniffed up, stuck on ADD, ICTED. You gon' get off of me, you gon' get off of me, you gon' get off of me, you gon' get off. Sticks and syringes to the needle, got HIV. Snort that white, but now you got a crack, baby. Off these drugs, we need to win. We in an energy crisis, we drink caffeine. One kid thinking it's cool to smoke cigs and weed. No high, no more, something stronger he needs. 11 tasting 12 and he drank Patron. 13 he got weed in the jar at home. 15 is peer pressure or his will. So 16 and he's off a pill. 18 MOB said police fled. Bread is dead, he needs something to sell. 19 in the basement and he's doing that rot. 20 busting knots, living life on the block. Addicted to polluting birds, dying by the flock. Clock goes tick tock. Strung up, hooked on, sniffed up, stuck on ADD, ICTED. You gon' get off of me, you gon' get off of me, you gon' get off of me, you gon' get off. Strung up, hooked on, sniffed up, stuck on ADD, ICTED. You gon' get off of me, you gon' get off of me, you gon' get off of me, you gon' get off. Why you inside? It's a beautiful day. Sedentary work and sedentary play. Virtual friend, MySpace addiction, and it's all into one overweight nation. I know it's cruel when this man ran world. We constantly kicking women to the curb, but I know you just want your voice to be heard. Don't stop. Your voice beautiful like a songbird. It's like Langston Hughes. What happened to a dream deferred? Quite often I find myself asking what happened to men walking on the street side. Cause of the music and no home training, my brain replied. What about opening doors and pulling out the chair? Finding a pair of gentlemen these days is so rare. Say it ain't fair, start living a life without men, without a care. Strung up, hooked on, sniffed up, stuck on ADD, ICTED. You gon' get off of me, you gon' get off of me, you gon' get off of me, you gon' get off. Strung up, hooked on, sniffed up, stuck on ADD, ICTED. You gon' get off of me, you gon' get off of me, you gon' get off of me, you gon' get off. Strung up, hooked on, sniffed up, stuck on ADD, ICTED. You gon' get off of me, you gon' get off of me, you gon' get off of me, you gon' get off. ADD, ICTED, ADD, ICTED, ADD, ICTED. You gon' get off me.
Thank you.
when you're not around.
Really? Anyways, I just don't feel it's right.
Oh, don't you worry, you're pretty level-headed about what's right. Anyway, only a few of us get to make it to the top of the factory, and that spot's already filled.
Are you saying what I think you're saying?
Honestly, I don't care what you think. What you need to do is be happy you're actually making it up in this world.
But...
Finish the day here, and tomorrow I'll be seeing you in level one.
Okay.
Thanks for standing up for me, but I'm used to it. Anyway, when you move to level one, you'll forget all about me.
No, I won't.
Trust, you will. And I'll never get out of here. I'm gonna be stuck here at this level forever. It seems like no matter how smart I am, no matter how fierce I am, I'm stuck like glue. I reach up with this dark brown hand and your huge brick hand knocks me down. I walk forward with these dark brown legs and your taunting words stand in my path. I try to move this dark brown body, but my limbs won't budge. Everyone here has become an enemy. My own people. My own flesh and blood even.
Whatever. What's next on the tour?
The final destination on today's tour. A place many never get to see. The belly of this beast we call the factory. Level 3. Tons of work for very low pay and practically no chance of getting out. Done from those behind bars, beyond borders, who will do the work that no one else will. The unseen, unnoticed, undocumented, the invisible.
This level's creeping me out.
Oh. Well, that's too bad. Because this is where I'll be leaving you.
What? No, you can't leave me here!
It's really not that bad. Trust
no,
me.
No, seriously, you can't leave me here!
I'm the pillow under your head, the one that cradles your dreams at but whose name you can't remember in the morning. I'm the tall-sized cat that assembles your shoes. The prisoner stitching my memories of open spaces into the seams of Victoria's Secret push-up bras. Shut away by walls and the myth that I'm different than you. I'm working my fingers to the bone, fertilizing the ground with my sweat. I'm eating empty calories for breakfast and disdain for lunch and every reservation, barrio, ghetto, and poor white trash town USA. Don't you recognize me? I didn't think so.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to offend you.
Don't worry. I got thick skin. It's one of the advantages of being invisible. Down here in level 3, it's either that or disappeared completely. What if you really want to get out of here? I might be able to point you in the right direction.
What? You can't get me out of here? To level 1?
Level 1? Is that what you really want?
Well, isn't... Honestly, I don't know what I want anymore.
Don't you remember anything? Anything that happened before you got here? Dang, they really cleaned you out.
So, you're saying there's a way to get me out of the factory?
I mean, there's gotta be, but don't go looking for any doors. It couldn't be that simple.
How do you know all this?
As I said, there are advantages to being invisible. I've heard there's a document that breaks it all down, a kind of roadmap out of this place.
Really? If I could just get my hands on it, then maybe
Well, I never heard that the document was getting ready to be blasted out of here in the next trash disposal.
What? Why didn't you get it if it's a ticket out of here?
Well, I guess I didn't believe it could be true. But you look desperate. You might as well try. You better hurry up, though. It's almost blast off time. Over there.
What? Over here?
Yes, just hurry. Hurry up.
So we can read it. Hope you guys don't mind getting a little dirty.
Don't worry, I'm not afraid of dirt.
Let's go.
Alright.
Thank you.
talent.
Anyway, where's the document?
I am a document. The Universal Declaration of Human Rights, whereas recognition of the inherent dignity and of the equal and inalienable rights of all members of the human family is the foundation of freedom, justice, and peace in the world.
Whoa, I remember this. I've read this before.
Good, maybe you can tell me what the heck it means.
It's a little confusing at first, but once you do, it starts to make sense. Just give it a chance.
All right, let's do it.
Look, let me put it to you like this. You are a human being, and so you are. You may not remember your dreams in the morning, but always you imagine something better. Peace, freedom, justice. Words like precious seeds you hold close to you. We've seen the devastation we can create. Every atrocity on the news, in our lives, in our neighborhoods. Reality has outraged the conscience of humankind, and your conscience won't let you stay asleep. I am a declaration, and I declare that the only foundation from which your seeds can grow is one where you respect everyone in your human family. Everyone. Either these rights must be written into the law, or the law is worthless. Either these rights must be written into our bones, or our case is hopeless. Write me into your laws. Write me into your bones. Take me from this page.
Wow. I can't believe they've been keeping this from us.
But it's been here all the time. I can't believe I got caught up in this game. My head feels like it's about to burst.
Man, I'm confused. How is reading this document supposed to get us out of here?
You know, I'm confused too. But being confused is better than being stuck in this illusion. We can figure this out.
I see a piece of a man, blinking slowly, talking quickly, he's alone and lonely, and his eyes hit me, I'm thinking, does he know me? He's past tipsy, but something told me to listen closely. I stopped in my tracks as he approached me. He smelled mostly of cheap scotch, he out on a gold watch that didn't tick, I'm thinking how ridiculous, but he moved even more closely. He reached in his coat and folds these sheets of loose leaf of poems that he hadn't finished composing. As his mouth was opening, his eyes were closing, and he said in a soft, raspy voice, "The reality is, you love fantasy. I prefer the reality of confusion to the seduction of illusion. So I understand that we last shortly, we are tiny, and our time is near. So what else is there except to be sincere? My peers appear to be dead or yet to be born, or perhaps they have not yet been loved by the norm and adored by the norm, then bored by the norm, then bold and scorned by the norm. People are funny, fickle, and dying. Our time is near. So what else is there except to be sincere? In a child's first year, and it's in search of its third year. In its 10th year, it's in search of its 16th year. In its 50th year, it's in search of its 25th year. And when it's dead, it's in search of its life. So why should it not be in search of now? You don't even have to search for now. Now it's here. Has now used you and abused you? Maybe now loves you and doesn't want to lose you. What if something accused you of not being good enough when it just met you? You hardly know now. For a couple dollars, I forked over the cash. He turned his head, turned his collar as we passed, and returned to a spot a half block up the Ave. We live in strange days. You'll find the truth out in many strange ways. Just keep your soul closed, cope and maintain. Some of those most deranged are really the best that stay insane. We live in strange days. You'll find the truth out in many strange ways. Just keep your soul closed, cope and maintain.
I was wrong.
Of us fall but still beat with the hope of rebirth.
do about this whole document thing?
Yeah, how are they gonna get us all out of here?
We can't stay here much longer. They're gonna catch up to us eventually.
Man, it's time to stop running.
Then what do we do?
I don't know yet. But something about this document can help us find the truth.
Man, what truth?
The truth about this game we're caught up in.
In the game!
In the game, you either win or lose.
In the game!
In the game, there will always be someone to fight against.
Someone to blame.
And us.
And the death. In the game!
There are many opportunities and our daily lives turn the other way.
To pretend that we're not connected.
Slap the iPod.
Turn on the TV.
Give up our rights. Forget that we have power to create change. We need to get this document to all the workers in the factory. We need to get them together. We need them to help us figure this out.
How are we gonna do that?
Don't worry about it. I think I can make that happen.
If you look through the smoke and mirrors, through the bars and barbed wire, through the bureaucracy and red tape, there is a way. There is an answer.
When I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. And in my hour of darkness, she is standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be, let it be, let it be.
are you all still doing here? Go!
I thought you could get all the workers here. Dude, what happened?
Man, how could you doubt me? I'm trusting you that we're gonna get out of here by reading some declaration, and you don't trust me to hack into the factory text messaging system? You should know better than that.
Is that what you did?
Wait. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
What is going on? What's the emergency?
Whoa, what is this place? It's completely off the map. I didn't even know it existed.
Yeah, what is this? I just got a high priority text message from the manager to be here right now. And who are you? I've never seen you before.
Level 3, baby. Level
3?
And both of you are level 1. That much I do.
Come on, you know I can't control that. And you're level 2?
Going nowhere fast.
I've never seen anyone from the other level before.
We've been separated for a reason. We're not meant to talk to each other.
See ya. Back to your business.
Wait. So there is no emergency, is there?
The emergency is that if we don't work together, we're stuck in this game.
What are you saying?
I'm saying we have rights.
Rights? What rights? Ah! Where did you come from? Who let you out?
They found me before you could get rid of me again.
Nobody needs the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. Who do you say you anyway? I know you inside and out, and you never helped me.
I wanted to, but after a while, you turned your back on me. You became someone I didn't recognize anymore. I didn't think you would fall into the game just like so many others.
I tried to defend you. I tried to make you law. Not enough people care.
There's some who never stopped. There's more who are beginning to care now.
Don't count on it. They're addicted to this factory. They're addicted to this mindless way of life. They're addicted to the rules that keep them in check. They don't want control. They don't want power. It's too much for them to handle. I gave up on them caring about their rights a long time ago.
If they don't care about their rights, then where do you think they are now?
Listen, rights or no rights, we're stuck in this game.
Look, this is the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. This is our way out of
Wait,
this place.
What? What? Isn't that like the forbidden document or something?
Yeah, and if they find us here, we're all toast.
You know what? I need to get out of here. Everyone should just come with me right now.
Oh, so now some level 1 worker's here to save the day?
I'm just trying to help you out. But you know what? Forget it. I don't need this.
Yeah, because the game's already working for you.
Whatever. I have worked for everything I have. What's your excuse?
This is ridiculous! You guys are so selfish! You're fighting over spots in the system that doesn't even recognize that I exist!
You think I don't know that? But what am I supposed to do about it? Just because I'm level 1 doesn't mean I have any real power.
Yeah, I feel so sorry for you, for real. The poor, sellout, token woman of color making it to the top. Oh.
Sellout? I'm level 1 because I deserve it. At least I'm not letting my race become a barrier for me.
You know what?
Okay. No matter what level we're from, we're all just people. And if we scream at each other, nothing gets fixed. We can work this out.
Dude, who let her old yeah, happy camping pills?
Shove it! Ah.
Like I said, rewind. We can work this out.
Shut up!
Dang, she told you.
Glitch, I'm gonna have to hurt you.
Hey, what happened to all the love?
You're always trying to make a joke out of everything. Snap out of your selfish little fantasy world, will you?
A little fantasy world?
Yes, oh, wait, he's so nice.
What? Oh, I hate you.
because maybe it's time.
Time for what?
Time for you to let go of control.
If I let go, this whole factory falls apart. They need me. They need someone to follow.
Is that what you really believe?
I don't know anyone.
Then tell me, what do you know?
I know that I've been disappointed one too many times. At first, I was excited about working together with others to make change, but I watched people get disillusioned. I watched them get tired and give up and drop out. It ate at me until I didn't even care anymore. All I wanted to do was to get mine, and the way you do that is by being the best at playing the game.
You see, this is what I'm talking about. As long as we're separate, we're stuck. Can't you all see that? We're being pitted against each other. We're living in separate worlds that hardly ever come together. And when they do, we can't even look at each other in the eyes. We're stuck because we're angry and afraid.
Man, no, I'm afraid. I'm afraid saying anything else will get my head chopped off.
Oh my God, man, you are a fool.
Yeah, I know. But I guess I hear what y'all are saying about me not taking anything seriously. I guess I hide in being a fool because it helps me from not feeling suffocated in this factory. If I don't hide in being funny and creating chaos, I'm gonna lose it completely. And it keeps me numb too.
What was that?
I said it keeps me numb too.
Yeah, I hear you. And I guess since you're getting all deep on us, I can take some responsibility for my part in this game. I mean, the game's messed up. There's no denying or getting around it. Our, including my own, hatred and discrimination is what's keeping it alive every single day. But sometimes, it just feels like I gotta have somebody to blame. But I can't make everybody my enemy. I gotta find my allies.
Yeah, but you have to find real allies. Not the ones that desert you when you need them the most. And I know that I did that to you.
You did what we were all trained to do.
But that isn't what it should be like. Instead of fighting this game, we just fight each other. And some of us ignore each other because we're ashamed of the privilege this game gives us. I acted like I did not have a choice, but I was promoted to level 1 at your expense. I could have not taken that position as a stance against the discrimination that you faced. And I won't do that again.
And I can take responsibility too. I just ignore what I know is true about the injustice in this game. I act like I don't have any power to make a difference, but I do. I just have to choose to.
Yeah, but for you, choosing to change is sacrificing everything. Are you sure you want to do that?
I don't know. I think so.
Well, I know. I'm tired. I'm tired of being invisible, feeling lonely because I can see you and you don't even know I exist. I'm tired of cleaning up after everyone without any recognition. I'm tired.
So, what do y'all want to do?
Well, maybe if we actually sit behind this document together, something will come out of it.
Okay, fine. Let's just read it.
So where's the document?
I feel your pain, but maybe it's time for real change now.
Change.
people are beginning to see through this illusion, through this game.
You know what? I almost forgot that I was even playing a game. But at this point, I don't think I can live without it.
This is not too late. The people deserve a chance to be free. You deserve a chance to be free.
I don't even know what freedom looks like.
Article 23. Everyone has the right to equal pay for equal work.
We can make a city, make a neighborhood, make a nation, make a world where productivity is measured in profit margins. But it is the people we draw out of margin labor.
Article 26.
Everyone has the right to an education.
We can make a place where intelligence is not measured with self-reflection, integrity, discipline, compassion, and self-esteem are the standards.
Where we're graded on the amount of times we engage in an open dialogue with somebody who is different.
On the amount of times we stand up for something that we know is right.
Article 19. Everyone has the right to freedom of opinion and expression.
Imagine a place where people are seen for who they are and their ideas are heard.
Article 25. Everyone has the right to a standard of living
adequate for the health and well-being of themselves and their families.
Imagine a place where we're not just barely getting by or getting ahead.
So, what are we going to do?
I'm going to encourage people not to exclude, generalize, or degrade any race of people.
I am going to be an ally to people of color.
I will vote in the next election.
I will take responsibility for my mistakes.
I will write down my thoughts.
I will make a conscious effort to speak my mind, regardless of the fear of what others might think or say. I will encourage my people to not make themselves invisible.
I will turn up my radio and make my own.
I will question everything.
I will be a positive role model.
I will help my community.
I will stop the N-word from my vocabulary and encourage others to say.
No man. I will make sure no man disrespects women in front of me.
Thank you.
one thing. I delink my girl and delink the stars and all the things. Girl, it's your party. That's right, feel like for your birthday. All day, all night, till I get to take a hike and get out of sight. Cause it's your party. Every day of the year, especially today, my girl, you know, play my girl. Put one in the air and scream like I hear. Move the body, baby.
attendance sheets. I can finally get that woman off my back.
Whoa, rise and shine.
Whoa, I got out.
I can't believe we did it.
Did what? Sleep through the whole class?
Class?
Yeah, class.
Hey, Glitch. Glitch,
what did you call me?
Glitch?
Maybe you should go back to sleep.
But what about all
I think all these human rights is getting to your head.
Human rights?
Your extra credit homework assignment.
Oh, yeah. I can't believe that nothing changed.
Well, I don't know if that's necessarily true. And sometimes change is slow. Kind of like a snail.
A snail?
Yeah. Grounded, patient, steady. Change is a discipline lived every day. And you just took the first step. But it's only the beginning.